guys, so recently Donald Trump has announced that J.D. Vance is his vice president, his vice president candidate. And this kind of came out of nowhere, especially since everybody has been kind of waiting a long time to find out who he was going to nominate for his vice president. Mm-hmm. And nobody, well, I don't want to say nobody, I don't know anything about J.D. Vance. I haven't heard anything about him. I've never looked him up politically. You said you heard some stuff about him.
Yeah, what he called Trump Hitler.
Well, yeah. That's even more confusing, because why would he allow this guy to be his vice president if he doesn't like him, if he was calling him Hitler?
But I know a lot of people don't like J.D. Vance. That's what I'm hearing.
He called Trump Hitler, or because of other things?
Because of other things, too. A lot of people say he ran Ohio in the ground.
So, what?
Yeah.
Okay, this is interesting. All right, well, I have a video here. It is, I guess it's going to be educating us a little bit on who this guy is. Anyway, y'all can leave your thoughts down below in the comment section. Let's go ahead and check this out.
He is the junior senator from Ohio with only 2 years in government. But J.D. Vance is one of former President Trump's biggest defenders.
I want to help Donald Trump get elected because it's really important that he become the next president.
In the Senate,
how can we defend Ukraine's borders when we're not even defending our own American border?
And on the campaign trail.
So the question is, are we going to send America First fighters to Washington, D.C.?
He's one of the leading voices of Trump's MAGA America First movement, not holding back and pushing the former president's agenda.
Republicans, we need to govern like we won the majority the American people gave us, not like a bunch of cowards.
But that hasn't always been the case. This was Vance in 2016.
Right, I'm a never Trump guy. I never liked him.
He was deeply critical of Trump then. But here's Vance just 6 years later.
The president is right. I wasn't always nice, but the simple fact is he's the best president of my lifetime, and he revealed the corruption in this country like nobody else.
Running for Senate in 2022 in Ohio as an extremely pro-Trump candidate.
I was wrong about Donald Trump. I didn't think he was going to be a good president, Brett. He was a great president.
Vance shot to fame as the author of Hillbilly Elegy.
So here's the thing.
He had a change of heart.
Yeah. And I don't see that any different than a lot of other people having a change of heart. Because during 2016, a lot of people spoke negatively about Donald Trump, and they had very bad things to say about him.
So why say things like that and you don't know the person and you don't know...
People do it all the time.
Yeah, that... But
didn't people say if Donald Trump won the election in 2020... Or if he won the election in 2016, they were going to move to Canada.
Yeah.
People were saying that
I heard Canada not doing so well.
Well, but that's the thing. People were saying that he was going to be the end of America, and you know, he was the worst thing that happened since Nixon. Yeah, right. And
I mean, a lot of people said a lot of things, but
And mudslinging goes on.
How can you say somebody's going to be Hitler and you don't know?
Right, yeah.
So, I mean, you can have a change of heart. You can change your mind, right. You know. And maybe after he's seen Donald Trump's track record, he
changed his mind. Right.
So you're allowed to change your mind.
Right, exactly. You know? And I feel like sometimes because we live in this world of, I guess, segregated politics, they don't allow you to change your mind. The way you felt years ago is how you feel now.
Right, because you have different information, right. Knowledge, you right. know. So, yeah, you can always change your mind.
Right.
But I think a lot of people in the beginning, like you said a lot of things, because, like, even Hillary Clinton, I think, they were kind of friends at first.
Yeah.
He went to their wedding. Like, Donald Trump was friends with everybody.
Right, exactly.
He was a very likable guy. A lot of people liked him. Mm. But as soon as he
ran for president, it's like the hate switch turned on.
Yeah, that's right. What it seemed.
And that's a perfect example.
Yeah.
Because you can go back years and see him rubbing elbows with the Clintons. Mm-hmm. And then all of a sudden, they're not good people to him. So it's just very interesting. The funny thing is, funny enough, I think a lot of people have changed their mind about Hillary Clinton as well. You know, they might have felt a certain type, a certain way about her in 2016, and now new information is out, and they don't like her as much. Anyway.
A memoir about his upbringing in a poor, hard-hit part of Ohio. He then enlisted in the Marines, went to Yale Law School and to venture capital, and then to the Senate, his first role in government. On the major issues, Vance has said he would support a national ban on abortion after 15 weeks, but is for exceptions, including for rape and the life of the mother. On immigration, Vance has called for finishing Trump's southern border wall. And on the issue of the 2020 presidential election, then-Senate candidate Vance suggested he would have supported fraudulent slates of pro-Trump electors.
If I had been vice president, I would have told the states like Pennsylvania, Georgia, and so many others that we needed to have multiple slates of electors, and I think the U.S. Congress should have fought over it from there. That is
now the father of two, just 39 years old, after not even a full 2 years in government, is set to step onto the biggest political stage in the world.
Wow. Very interesting. All right. So now that we have a little bit more information about J.D. Vance, what do you think?
I don't know about him.
He's very young.
Oh, that's a good thing.
Yeah. I mean, people have been asking for get some young blood in the D.C., so.
Yeah.
You know? I mean, and then, of course, he'd be next in line for president if anything happened to Donald Trump. Do you think he would be a good president? Mm-mm. No? No. Why not?
I want to keep those things to myself.
Okay, yeah, fair enough.
Because
something about him doesn't rub you the right way?
I don't have enough information to go on.
Okay, right.
That's why.
All right.
And I'm going to leave it
at that. Okay, fair enough. You know, and I agree with those sentiments. You know what I'm saying? I think that this was just a brief synopsis of some of the things that he's done. You know, you mentioned that he made negative comments or disparaging comments about Donald Trump in the past, in which they may have been sound bites. We don't really have too much context behind them. But yeah, I reserve that. I don't know enough of information about J.D. Vance to really make a decision on whether I think he would make a good president. But from what I have seen and what I do see is I wouldn't want him to be my vice president. But that's just me.
Yeah. So.
But anyway, guys, we'd love to hear your thoughts. You can leave them down below in the comment section. As always, like, share, and subscribe. And we will see y'all next time. Take care. Peace.